إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers and sisters, today I want to speak about a very important topic that is almost affecting most of the Muslim families and even individuals. How many person was harmed in himself because of that? And how many person lost his wealth because of that? And how many person had an accident because of that? And how many person his future was destroyed because of that? Even how many person passed away and was put in the grave in the qabr because of that? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن العين حق. Indeed, the evil eye is true, is a fact. أخرج أحمد في مسنده والنسائي ومالك في الموطأ وغيرهم من حديث سهل بن حنيف رضي الله عنه. Sahl was a Sahabi and he was having very good body, mashallah, and very white skin, very good appearance and looking. One day they were with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam traveling and they stopped near Al-Juhfa at a place called Al-Jarrar. So Sahl ibn Hunayf went to have a bath, a shower. So he was wearing a jubba, something like this, covering most of the body. He took off his jubba. There was another Sahabi called Amir ibn Rabi'a. When Sahl took off his jubba, Amir said, مَا رَأَيْتُكَ الْيَوْمِ وَلَا جِلْدَ مُخَبَّأَ وَفِي رواية وَلَا جِلْدَ عَدْرَاءَ. Amir, when he saw the white skin and the very good looking of the body of Sahl, he said, I have never seen like what I saw today, like what I'm seeing now. Means from the wonderful and amazing appearance and the white skin, even a skin of a virgin. Usually the girls are protected and the skin is very white. So Amr was saying, I have never seen such a skin, such a wonderful skin. What happened? فَلُبِطَ سَهْلٌ فِي الْحَالِ. Sahl رضي الله عنه immediately He became ill and sick and he lost his consciousness. He cannot talk. After some time, they went to the Prophet ﷺ and told him, Sahm felt sick and he cannot move with us. The Prophet ﷺ said, هَلْ تَتَّهِمُونَ بِهِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ. Do you accuse someone for what happened to him? They told him the story about Amr. That when Amr saw him, he said this sentence. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Amr and he was so angry with him. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام على ما يقتل أحدكم أخاه هل بركت إذا رأيت ما يعجبك. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, why one of you kills his brother. لا إله إلا الله. Amr didn't kill. Amr didn't do anything. Just he said, wow, what a wonderful skin I have never seen before. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, didn't you say, Allahumma barik? Didn't you say, Tabarakallah? Why you did not say this? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered Amr to make a special wudu. And this will come in the treatment. Inshallah ta'ala, that Amr washed his body in a special way and gave this remaining water of Amr, the person who harmed by his eyes, gave this water to Sahm, the sick person. Then they poured on his head from the back, on the neck, and the rest of the body. Immediately he became cured and healed. And he went with the Prophet ﷺ as if he had nothing. Subhanallah al-Azim. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم العين حق ولو كان شيء سابق القدر لسبقته العين وإذا استغسلتم فاغسلوا. This hadith in Sahih Muslim that the Prophet ﷺ said, indeed evil eye is true is a fact. And if something would precede the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it would be the evil eye. And if you are ordered, if you are requested to take a bath as cure for your brother, take a bath for your brother. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم أكثر من يموت من أمتي بعد قضاء الله وقدره بالعين. رواه البخاري في تاريخه ليس في صحيحه والبزار في المسند وحديث حسن. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned in this hadith, most of my ummah who die, they die out of the evil eye. لا إله إلا الله. Listen my brother, listen my sister. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, most of my ummah, they die out of the evil eye after the destiny of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah al-Azim. Many people, they have two extremes in this issue. Some people, they are so careless. Oh, you are saying this something we don't see and you are making it very big and very huge issue. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that. Even Allah jalla jalalu mentioned that in the Quran in more than one ayah. قال جل جلاله in the end of Surah Noon, وَإِنْ يَكَادُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَيُسْلِقُونَكَ بِأَبْصَارِهِمْ لَمَا سَمِعُوا الذِّكْرِ. And indeed, those who disbelieve, they are almost going to slip you with your eyes. They are going to harm you with your eyes. قال ابن كثير يُعِينُونَكَ بِأَبْصَارِهِمْ يُصِيبُونَكَ بِالْعَيْنِ. Harm you with their eyes when they listen to the Quran out of jealousy and envy. العلماء رحمهم الله, they mentioned that العين, evil eyes coming out from the evil eye of an envious person, having envious soul, وَالْعَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, having evil soul, وَالْعَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. That's why it's harming others. وقال جل جلاله قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إلى العقد، ومن شر النفاثات في العقد، ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. قال قتادة رحمه الله: من شر عينه ونفسه. قتادة said, seek refuge from the evil of his eye and his soul. Eye and soul. وقال ابن القيم رحمه الله: كل عائل حاسد. فلما كانت الاستعاذة من الحسد شملت العين والحسد. Every evil-eyed person is an envious person. That's why when we seek the refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from hasad, it's including seeking the refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil eye as well. And one day, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as was narrated from Sahih Muslim, دخل على أسماء بنت حميس رضي الله عنها فقال: ما لي أرى بني أخي أجسام بني أخي ضارعة أي نحيفة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saw the children of أسماء. He said, why I see the bodies of those children, the children of my brother, why I see their bodies so thin and weak. أمن هذا؟ You are poor, you don't have money to buy food. قالت: لا يا رسول الله، ولكن تسرع إليهم العين. أسماء رضي الله عنها said, no, O Messenger of Allah, but it's coming quick to them to harm them, the evil eye. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ابقي. Make ruqya for them. Do ruqya for them. And many, many, many other evidences that's proving from the Quran and Sunnah that this issue is very, very critical issue. And wallahi, how many bride, after they make her so beautiful for her husband, before even the wedding, before the wedding, she passes away and they put her in grave. And how many couples on the day of nikah ceremony, on the same day after they finish the nikah ceremony, because of the evil eye, they don't reach home. They are in grave at night. My dear brothers, on the other hand, some people are believing that every single harm and every single problem and hardship they face in their life, العين والحسد, everyone is affecting me by his evil eye, everyone is jealous from me, everyone having envy towards me, and that is another extreme. How to be balanced and how to protect yourself, inshallah, in the second khutbah, ادعوا الله وانتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده النبي الأمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى صحابته الغر الميامين ومن اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، My dear brothers, the evil eye is coming from an evil soul, definitely. But not every single evil eye is considered as envy, hasad. Hasad is to wish, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, that your brother will lose the blessing of Allah, will lose his handsomeness, will lose his beauty if he is handsome, will lose his wealth if he is wealthy, will lose his health if he is healthy, will lose his kids, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, if he has a lot of kids, or if he got boys and you got girls, and so on. This will add to billah min al-kaba'ir al-hasad. But sometimes the evil eye even comes from your own self. To your own self. If you look at the mirror, mashallah, you are well dressed. And mashallah, you had a new dress, good looking, and you are looking with admiring looking. You will harm yourself. If you did not say, Allahumma barik, ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. ولولا أن دخلت جنتك قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned on the tongue of the righteous man advising the owner of the two gardens in Surah Al-Kahf. My dear brothers, many children are affected first by their parents. Wallahi, first by their parents before others. You think you are seeing the joy of your eyes and you are so admiring them, astonished by them. Sometimes if you don't say the dua, you will affect them. They become sick, they become ill, they become backward in their studying, they will lose their skills and so on because of your own evil eye. Be careful. The balanced way, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, to have a very well shield every day. You must put the shield. Some people think they are affected by envy or hasad because they are abnormal ones, because they are super duper and best of the best. So everyone is jealous from them. It's not about this, my brother. Every one of us has blessings from Allah. Everyone. And everyone can be affected and harmed by the evil eye if he is not protected. It's all about the protection. When you are affected, it's not because you are the best and everyone is jealous from you. No, it's because you are not well protected by the adhkar. It's because you are missing to make the shield which Rasulullah ﷺ taught us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. You had these shortcomings, that's why the arrows of the jinn and the ins may affect you. And hasad also may happen from the jinn, not even from humans. And it may happen from humans, and it may happen mixed with envy and jealousy. That's why, number one, my dear brothers and sisters, we are living in a time, terrible time, for this SNS or the social media, that everyone is sharing every detail in his life. Taking dinner with his wife, privately, taking a photo on Facebook, Instagram. We are taking the dinner in this tower, 5-star hotel. Subhanallah al-Azim. And maybe others, they are suffering. They don't have a wife. They don't have money to go to that place. They don't. You are affected, Habibi. Why are you doing like this? This is lack of mind, lack of logic. To expose everything in your life for people. Now I'm traveling from here to there. Now I'm taking a flight to there. Now I'm doing like this. Now I'm doing like this. Brother, you will be affected. You are the one. Don't blame except yourself. And how many persons from these YouTubers or this, they call them the high influencers on the social media, they died because of the evil eye of people. Wallahi, they died recently. A lot of stories. Just they take the videos every day, every few hours they take few new videos sharing the details of their life. Then she lost her eyes. Another one, accident, and his new car totally destroyed. Another one, divorce after he's sharing the huge love with his wife. Why you share the love of your wife in front of others? Subhanallah al-Azim. What is this? Then don't blame yourself. Don't blame except yourself when you have a big fight with your wife. How many persons are seeing these posts? If one person is enough, if he saw you, without your protection and shield from adhkar, you may be affected like Amir with Suhail, with Sahil ibn Hanayf. How about sharing in front of thousands and hundreds of thousands or millions of followers? Come on, my brother. Where is the logic in this? This is totally away from the balanced way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he taught us. As it was narrated, استعينوا على قضاء حوائجكم بالكتمان. Take the support to accomplish what you need by keeping it secretly. Why to expose everything in your life, subhanAllah al-Azim? That is number one. Number two, to have tawakkul upon Allah and to believe that nothing will harm you in this life except after the permission of Allah Jalla Jalalu. Even everyone is trying to look at you and to harm you, if you have tawakkul upon the old king, the true king, Allah Jalla Jalalu, nothing will harm you. Number three, to say the adhkar. Say Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma ismihi shay'un fil ardi wa la fis samaa wa huwa as-sami'ul 'aleem thrice in the daytime and night time. It's a must to say it. You cannot skip it. Say it for yourself and put your hands on the forehead of your children and say it to them before sleeping in the morning and in the afternoon. It's a must. A'udhu bi kalimati Allahi tammati min sharri ma khalaq. A must to say three times in the daytime and the night time. This is very important adhkar to protect you. It's a must to say قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ thrice in the morning, in the evening, before sleeping, and once after every salah. That is the real shield and protection. Whatever jinn and ins will try to harm you, alhamdulillah, you are totally protected. And last, that we mentioned in the beginning of the khutbah, how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Amir to take the special wudu and give this remaining water for Sahl. He told him to wash his hands and the front of his face and his elbows, المرافق, and his knees and the front of his feet and inside this part, the private part, to put water inside and let the water to come out. All this remaining water, we take it from the person who is accused and we pour this water on the sick or ill or affected person. Inshallah, he will be totally cured by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Rasulullah mentioned something very important. He said, وَإِذَا اسْتُغْسِلْتُمْ فَغْسِلُوا. If someone came to you and said, my brother, sorry, I feel you affected me. I feel when you saw me yesterday with this dress or with that bicycle or with my car or whatever, I had a problem, I feel I need your wudu. Please make wudu for me and give the remaining water for me. Prophet said what? If someone requested you so, you have to do it. Don't say, why are you asking me? I never do like this. I have nothing with you, brother. Go away. My heart is clean. You are accusing me. No, don't be angry. You may accuse someone mistakenly. If someone told you, please, I need your wudu, you immediately do it. And I know, alhamdulillah, many people, mashallah, they are already very pure-hearted. And when they feel they affected someone, they will make this wudu and they will give this remaining water to the person they are afraid they affected them, and they will take the water. Alhamdulillah, it's totally cured. Take it easy. If this happened between the Sahaba, then don't think you cannot do like this. No. If someone requested you to do so, then do it. Do it with a pure heart towards your brother, because that is, subhanAllah, something came out in an admiring way or surprising way. Maybe it affected your brother in his health or wealth or children or family or with his wife or in his job, career or path or whatever. Be careful. Keep your adhkar. Keep the shield and protection. Ask the refuge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from al-ayn, as was narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he said, استعيذوا بالله من العين. asked the refuge of Allah from the Ayn. And he ordered Aisha radiallahu anha to ask Allah's refuge from the evil eye. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min al-ayn wal-hasad. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من العين والحسد. اللهم احفظنا من عين العائنين وحسد الحاسدين وشر الكائدين. اللهم إنا نسألك الحفظ والعناية يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك العافية في الدنيا والآخرة، نسألك العفو والعافية في ديننا ودنيانا، ونسألك العفو والعافية في أهلنا وأموالنا. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا. اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا، ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نبتلى من تحتنا. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وجميع موتى المسلمين. اللهم اقض الدين عن المدينين من المسلمين، ونفس كرب المكروبين من المسلمين. اللهم اكشف هم المهمومين من المسلمين. اللهم اكشف هم المهمومين من المسلمين. اللهم افك اسرانا وجميع اسرى المؤمنين. اللهم كل اخواننا المستضعفين من المؤمنين والمسلمين في كل مكان برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا من الظالمين. ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم انا نسالك من الخير كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم، ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله واجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. والحمد لله رب العالمين.